Hello, this is Sanjay Sane. In this video, we are going to see some few more examples related to normal distribution. So this is our next example in which weights are assumed to be normally distributed with mean 180 and sigma 30. What fraction of the males or may weigh more than 200 pounds? Well, so as has been given over here that X, which are basically weights, weight in pounds, follows a normal distribution, you know, with mean 180 and sigma square 30 square. Fine. So over here, what has been asked is probability that X takes values more than 200 pounds. That has been actually asked. Fine. Let's draw the bell-shaped curve relevant to our problem statement. So considering this bell-shaped curve here, this actually being the exactly middle of it, well, this being 180, well, 180. What we want is, you see, 200, okay. The value, you know, I can say that we want area under the curve, you see, this one. Okay, so this is basically the probability what actually we want over here. This is this probability. Okay. Now, as you very well know, in the previous problem, we had to find probability at the in the left region. Now we want to find probability in the right region. Okay. Now the function CDF, which we already saw, addresses probability that X is less than or equal to or something like a particular number. Now over here, we have a requirement of probability of greater than. Well, one thing is possible that we may be finding for doing this. One alternative can be that we finding the value of probability X less than or equal to 200 or maybe less than 200 using CDF function and you know, subtracting that probability from one. Okay, that is one alternative using CDF function. Second alternative can be using SF function. Now this SF function directly addresses the expression of probability of X bigger than a certain value. So we are going to use this SF function. Hence, this is our way of solving the problem. Either we call CDF function subtract one minus that CDF function call, we may be getting the area under this curve or directly use SF function for that. Let us execute these two statements in our Jupyter notebook. You see over here that this has been already written and I run this, I get the probability. Also, the same thing can be executed here, we can get the same probability. Well, this is the way we can use this SF function.